So I want to talk about types of goods. I think I mentioned some few, but so we have normal goods. Normal goods, when income increases, demand for the good increases. So any good that has this property is a normal good. And we have inferior goods. When income increases, demand for the good decreases. So that is an inferior good. And we have substitute goods. Substitute goods. A decrease in demand for one good causes an increase in demand for the other. So any good that has its demand decreasing as a result of an increase in demand for the other is a substitute. So for ideal milk and pig milk, my normal example, ideal milk and pig milk, for instance, it is likely that when the demand for ideal milk increases, the demand for pig milk will decrease, because those who used to demand pig milk have shifted to the demand of ideal milk. So such goods are called substitutes, right? Oh, let me give another example. You know Bonvita. Bonvita is a chocolate drink, and Milo. Milo is also a chocolate drink. So if you have Bonvita and Milo in the house, if you increase your consumption for Milo, you reduce your consumption for Bonvita, because they are almost the same thing. So such goods are called substitutes. Great. Then we have complementary goods. Complementary goods, they are goods that are used together. So a decrease in the price for one good leads to an increase in the demand for the other. So if the price decreases, the good becomes less expensive. As it becomes less expensive, people will buy more of that good. But you cannot use that good alone. You have to use it for another good. So as you buy more of that good, there will be an increase in the demand for the other good that is used together with it. Such goods are called complementary goods. Yes, so an example is petrol and car. When car prices decrease, demand for fuel increases, because people buy more cars and they will need to fill those cars with fuel. And also we have types of demand. We have complementary or joint demand. When two or more commodities are jointly demanded at the same time to satisfy a particular want, it is called joint or complementary demand. Example is car and fuel, demand for milk, sugar, tea bag for making tea. They are all used together. Yeah, so they have complementary demand. Then we have competitive demand. When two or more commodities give consumers similar satisfaction or perform similar functions to the consumer, then the goods are considered as substitutes or substitute goods, or are in competitive demand. An example is iPhone and Samsung, Pepsodent and Close-Up toothpaste, and others. They offer almost the same satisfaction. They give the same satisfaction to the consumer. Great. Then the next is composite demand. Composite demand, the demand for a commodity which can be put to several uses. You can demand for a commodity and that commodity can be used for a lot of things. An example is demand for electricity. Electricity can be used to cook. Electricity can be used to power your vehicle. There are now electric cars. Electricity can be used for household, your television, your sound system, and others. So it's used. It has several uses. That is composite demand. It is a total demand for a commodity for different purposes. Another example is cassava. When you demand for cassava, probably it is because you are using it. You can use it for gari, you can use it for fufu, you can use it for starch and others. So it has a composite demand. Then we have derived demand. Derived